गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. आई एम प्रोफेसर जानकी मिस्त्री फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर पारुल यूनिवर्सिटी. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंडक्ट वन ऑफ द वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इंफॉर्मेटिव एज वेल एज प्रोडक्टिव वेबिनार ऑन अ वाइटल टॉपिक विच इज एग्रीकल्चरल बिजनेस स्टार्टअप एंड इनक्यूबेशन. We all know that agriculture plays an important role in Indian economy, and more than 50% of rural household depends upon the agriculture for their principal means of livelihood. As technological boost is the major requirement of this industry, much effort should be made in advancement of this sector, leading to agri startups and agribusiness, which enterprising farmers practices in a profitable agriculture. This sector now streaming with educated youth as well as their ideas, innovations and passion to launch the new technology as well as business models to lift agriculture from a primitive to high-tech one. To convert these innovative ideas into a business, a kind of incubation is a must needed. By doing so, the emerging talents can obtain the guidance and funding for establishing and managing their business. Today in our seminar, the chairman of today's webinar is our respected Dean and Principal, Sir Dr. Chandrakant Sharma, sir. Welcome, sir. And the speaker of today's webinar is Dr. Mahesh Kadam, sir. Welcome, sir. For talking about him, he is the manager of marketing as well as communication and agribusiness incubator at National Institute of Agricultural Marketing under Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare at Jaipur, Rajasthan. Sir is a dynamic and enterprising professional in the field of agri economics with a PhD and have a diverse experience in teaching, research, as well as extension activities. Also, agribusiness incubation, startups concerned with agriculture, as well as agricultural allied activities, agribusiness planning, as well as models, setting up farmer-producer companies, legal aspects with farmers, and their allocative perspective in determining ways and means to improve their standard of living. He's also into teaching desirable input-output techniques, price determination, welfare boundaries to strategic the tax system in developing countries. So now I firstly would like to invite our principal and dean, sir, Dr. Chandrakant Sharma, sir, to please share your valuable words to our audience. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Janaki ji. As you have quoted multiple things about the agriculture sciences in present era, in my belief, none of the country can sustain without the farming. So any country has to fulfill the demand of the food, and it has been quoted on the multiple platforms by the FAO. And if you see, nowadays, agriculture is not a kind of traditional agriculture where you do the farming by the traditional ways. It has involved multiple technologies. It has involved AI. It has involved drones. It has involved the multiple things at the different levels, starting from sowing to the reaping. So now the question arises, how it can be upskilled? Upskilling can be done by some kind of the ventures which can be started as the startup. And as per the present government of India, and as per our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi ji, he's having a kind of vision for supporting the young minds to start the startups related with the agriculture. Because we have the produce which are sufficient, but sometimes it has been observed we are not able to conserve, we are not able to preserve. So there are some kind of opportunities which are available to boost the economy through the startup. So that today's webinar is very much relevant in that concern. Before talking about that, I want to give a kind of highlight about our esteemed Parul University. Esteemed Parul University is leading under the dynamic leadership of Honorable President Sir Dr. Devanshu Patel Sir. In the Faculty of Agriculture, we are offering the degree in the Agriculture Sciences, Dairy Technology, Agriculture Engineering, and recently we have opened the Diploma in Animal Husbandry. So we are catering the need of the society in the education domain. Now, for the today's topic, our eminent speaker, Dr. Kadam, is with us, and I think he will clear the doubts as well as he will equip you regarding the startups. Dr. Kadam, please. Thank you, Dr. Thank you, Janakiji.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for enlightening the upcoming views and concerns regarding agriculture, then moving with agribusiness and upcoming entrepreneurship as well as upcoming startup ecosystem. So I will share the slides first. But the slides are visible, sir?
Yeah, it's visible. Please go for the slideshow.
Yeah. Okay. So first of all, I want to welcome one and all the students, upcoming agripreneurs, all the faculties concerned, and all the stakeholders concerned with agriculture. So on the behalf of CCS NIAM, National Institute of Agriculture Marketing, Jaipur, and NIAM Agribusiness Incubator, I welcome you for this upcoming and very innovative session on agribusiness startups and agri ecosystem concerned with agribusiness. Now, talking about CCS NIAM is the country's premier National Institute of Agriculture Marketing, focusing on research, education, consultancy, and training. CCS NIAM have total 10 centers, up to which we have Center of Innovation, Entrepreneurship, and Skill Development. Under this department, we have a knowledge partner workout with RQI Raftar program, which was established in the year 2017-18 by the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare. So coming up with the views of different government scheme for the efficient agro ecosystem for the agri startups, we have very imminent scheme that is Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana, called as Remunerative Approaches for Agriculture and Allied Sector Rejuvenation. Then we have generalized scheme Startup India, which focus on upcoming agriculture, industry and service sectors. Then we have a very imminent scheme called as Atal Innovation Scheme, focusing all the three major sectors, that is agriculture, industries and service sector. Then we have New Gen Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development Center under National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board. Further, we have specialized scheme on Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme promoted by National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development. Then in PP mode, that is public-private, we have Venture Capital Finance Assistance Scheme promoted by Small Farmers and Agribusiness Consortium. Then we have Aspire, focusing micro, small and medium enterprises. Further, we have Agri Udan, focusing on food and agribusiness startups, as well as we have a very iconic term called as Accelerator. Then we have Center for Innovation, Incubation and Entrepreneurship, focusing in 16 different institutions pan-India. Then we have Agri-Tech Startup Accelerator situated in Hyderabad. Then we have specialized product, or we can say service-based incubation centers at International Crop Research Institute for Semi-Arid Tropic, that is ICRISAT, focusing Food Processing Business Incubator and Agribusiness Incubator. These all programs and policies aim to support existing and budding ventures, enterprises and startups in agriculture by training, mentoring and financing. So coming up, why we need or what is the scope in order to commercialize agriculture? As we know very well, if you see the scenario of agriculture, before Green Revolution, it was in a situation of sustainable agriculture. Then the cycle moved with commercial agriculture with high yielding varieties. Then further, we move with some agribusiness management activities. Then we move with some technological based agriculture. Then further, we pushed up with entrepreneurship. And now the era of startups have come up in agriculture in order to promote or as well as in order to allocate the resource in agriculture. So coming up with resource use, we focus on Millennium Development Goals to Sustainable Development Goals. As we know, the cycle is moving. It is moving from sustainable agriculture, commercial agriculture, then moving with entrepreneurship agriculture. And again, the entrepreneurship agriculture is moving to the sustainable goals. So if you talk about the major sustainable goals, which focus on agriculture and innovation in agriculture, first, it is needed to overcome the poverty, then overcome the zero hunger, further good health and well-being. As we are very well aware about this COVID time, COVID situation, I think only the sector which is self-sustained and it is helping other sectors also to come up and in balanced approach, it is only the agriculture concern. Then we have moving to the point of responsible consumption and production, then further life below water as well as life on land. So a balanced approach is maintained with the help of agriculture and upcoming innovations. Now talking about the major resource, that is the population. As we know, as the population is increasing day by day, the allocative resource use efficiency is also increasing. So we require some tech-based innovations. We require some upcoming conventional to innovative ways of innovation so we can fulfill the need of population by the help of agriculture. The major challenges for this is the climate, or we can say climate risks. If you see the scenario of climate risks in the upcoming panorama globally, we can say that the challenges are increasing day by day. But we have to come up, we have to overcome it with new innovations which can help and balance the agriculture as concern. Talking about again Global Hunger Index, we are reaching up to the rank of 103 in the year 2017. But now talking about 2021, it has reached up to 119. So we have to take care that we know that the food grain production is increasing day by day. But if you see the land or the fragmentation of land, it is increasing as a concern to the productivity level. So we require some good innovations, good startups, which can help to balance this resource approach also. Now talking about the ecological footprints, it helps to maintain the balanced approach of the urbanization as well as the agriculture part, then the upcoming resources, which may be a forest land, fulfilling with carbon footprint, fulfilling the need of cropland, as well as the resources which are available through sea or marine areas. So this ecological footprint help to manage all this as a concern with upcoming innovations. Talking about India today, more than 17% of world human as well as even percent livestock population is upcoming or it is there existing in India. 4.2% of world water is proportionated with India only. 2.4% of world's area is also achieved by India. 142 million hectares cultivated under India and 660 million hectares is net irrigated area in India. We have reached up to 138% of cropping intensity. Near about 52% of population earns livelihood in agriculture. 13.9% is contributed in GDP through as well as in upcoming developing countries also if you can. 10% of earning come from the total exports. Now this scenario gives us the proper picture how the agriculture moves from pre-independence area to post-independence area. So all this panorama moves with the upcoming innovations which have taken place pre-Green Revolution as well as post-Green Revolution areas. As we know very well, Norman Ebog, we know he is the innovation, or we can say father of the innovation in Indian agriculture with the step-by-step with M.S. Swaminathan. So here we determine why the innovation is helping and why this I factor is playing very important role in India. So major innovation moves with innovation in agriculture, input management, incentives for agriculture, investment in agriculture, and lastly, dealing with institutional infrastructure, which will help in order to organize this innovation and it will fulfill the upcoming generations. Talking about the resource content, here we have taken a paradigm of small farmer. As we know that near about 85% of farmers have less than 2 hectares of cultivated land. So the upcoming innovation must focus on low cost, agronomically designed multi-purpose farm equipment, which can help these 85% farmers to do the agriculture in a very proper decorum, and which can help to increase the productivity also. Talking about the current status of agriculture, if you see the scenario, the GDP is reaching up to 14%, but the scenario concerned with resources, it is decreasing day by day. So we have to come up with a proper approach with the help of innovation, which can help to increase the productivity as well as maintain the GDP concern. Talking about the farmers' income or the farmers' income dealing with all the industry services, wage employment, skilling area, 48% is contributed by agriculture only. Either it is through the unorganized or organized way, it is directly depending upon agriculture only. Here we have seen the comparative picture pre-green revolution area and post-green revolution area. It shows that the production is increasing day by day, but the resource use efficiency, we are little bit in challenging situation. For that reason, we require the upcoming innovations. The major propaganda which was given by Dr. Dalwai dealing with doubling the farmers' income, the major impact was given on these four parameters, that is integrate. We have to integrate the different resources or different sectors so that we can come up with the yield as well as the productivity in agriculture. We have to diversify the sectors also so that there is no monopoly or dependency on one resource or one sector. We have to come up with some cluster approach. Now, if you see the upcoming schemes in agriculture, if you see the food processing sector or farmer producer organization, they are focusing on this cluster approach only. Then we have come up with a scenario of cut cost. Either we are moving with technology, either we are moving with innovations, so that it is helping to reduce the concern of resources and helping to yield the productivity. Then upcoming innovations under IUV will help us in order to increase the productivity, then value addition, then 3 M's, which we must help the farmers also to understand very well, that is the monsoon, market, and the mindset. Mindset is concerned with the psychology, whether when we determine the price or the value of that particular commodity. Then we have to come up with 4 P's, which is very important to increase the farmers' income through innovation way, that is to produce, protect, concerned with logistic or warehouses. Then if it is more, then we have to come up with process, and with the process we are coming up to value addition, which leads to prosperity for the farmers as well as all the stakeholders which are dealing with agriculture. Now, talking about the future of the food and farming area, we have seen the population is increasing, but if you see the scenario or the innovations which are taking place in agriculture, first innovation, or we can say first reach, was on the food only. We have coming up with the green revolution. We have increased the food production. Then we have focused on animal husbandry, that we have increased the feed for the people as well as for the upcoming livestock. Then we are moving with the fodder. Now, if you see the today's scenario, we are moving with fiber and fuel. So more and more innovations are needed on this last two, we can say F, that is the fiber and fuel. So we can maintain the energy level as well as the upcoming productive level in agriculture. New agriculture, which require more innovations, is on more from less for more. Means more and more value-added product, which will help us in order to gain more income. Then starch to protein to health foods. Today's scenario, if you see in COVID condition, we are focusing on this starch to protein to health food concept. Then overcome the stretch agriculture. Either the stretch may be concerned with market or it may be concerned with monsoon. We have to come up with some innovation which will help agriculture as well as the stakeholders in agriculture to overcome it and earn more income. We have to focus more on secondary agriculture, means the processing way. Then specialty agriculture, either specialty dealing with information technology or dealing with technology transfer, we have to focus in that particular direction. Then we have to come up new agriculture from agriculture, food, nutrition, health, environment, and lastly, focusing employment. we have to come up with one chapter that is called as One Health, which deal with soil, plant, animal, and man approach. And lastly, all this we can focus on skill and youth in agriculture. So some glimpses of smart farming for the small farmers. If you see the scenario, the major resource in agriculture is the water. So we have come up with innovation to conserve the water, but the upcoming innovation must help in order to use or how to manage the water so that it can be utilized for the production of cereal, pulses, as well as upcoming horticulture production. Now, if you see the benchmark, this scenario is showing that the horticulture production is increasing day by day. And as the production is increasing, we require more and more water. So upcoming innovation must be there in order to concern with water. These are the some innovation dealing with nano fertilizers, how this fertilizer is helping in order to increase the productivity of soybean as well as the maize, so it can reach up to the proper root level and it will help to increase the productivity. These are the some innovation in agriculture dealing with protected cultivation, either greenhouse, polyhouse, pack houses. Then by growing high value crops, either it may be turmeric crop, then it may be leafy vegetable, it may be some foreign vegetables. Urban agriculture, we are helping in order to reduce the stress of the farmers or in order to come up with a hobby-based agriculture for the upcoming urban people who can come up with terrace farming, vertical farming, it may be some tray gardening. So it will help in order to increase the innovations in agriculture. Then floating horticulture will help. It's very useful or very innovation. Why? Because it requires very low cost infrastructure. It deals with waste utilization, including polythene bag, and it will come up with aquatourism also. This is example of vertical farming in order to increase the value addition in horticulture crop. Then we have hydroponics, terrace farming. You're very well aware about this. So these are the, we can say, step-by-step innovations in agriculture, which help in win-win situations for both, for the farmers, for the urban people, and for getting good healthy food also. Some indigenous crop, we have to focus or we have to come up with some innovations. Why? Because due to their nutritional values. Now we are focusing on crops like avocado, caper, cactus, olai, quinoa, tuff, which can help in order to keep the places of the nutritional as well as the balanced approach of environment also. So it will help in order to increase the nutri farms. Then some innovation dealing with animal husbandry, either it is dealing with goatery, piggery, or dealing with woolen. All this concern will help in order to increase the income of the farmers as well as dealing with some export foreign exchange also. Dealing with marine, we have a very vast area for the innovation part. Either it is moving with inland fisheries, marine fisheries, dealing with upcoming components, dealing with pearl cultivation, as in case. Then we have a very innovative concept called as the agrotourism, which is playing very important role. I think ornamental fish farming, diversification for the human livelihoods, then sport fishing and conservation. Some local innovation is also transforming agriculture and increasing the income of farmers. Here we see the pictures, very manual way of puddling, then very techno-based dealing with interculture operations which are carried out, then the ways and means to reach up to that particular level, then manual made fridge conditions which is helping to increase the shelf life of the crops. These are the some upcoming agricultural innovations where small farmers can easily come up with a method of custom hiring, where he can come up with a farmer producer company where in rent basis he can purchase that particular equipment on rent and can utilize in this agriculture concern to increase its productivity. There are some example of Noel Jute geotextile developed for construction of concrete roads also. These are some glimpses which has helped the green revolution with the help of innovations like tractor operated pneumatic plant for small seeds, then lychee peeling machine, then banana fiber extracted for textile use, doffing system for double rural gin to reduce dust emission. Then we have biomass based power generation for developed by agro enterprises. Then we have woman friendly fish vending unit, palm planting device with safety attachment, and cryogenic spice grinding machine. Under the platform Make in India, some innovative products have developed in agriculture, like nanocellulose products in the form of gel, powder, liquid. Then we have established a nanocellulose pilot plant where 10 kg per day upcoming products have been developed. Then we have innovative fish feed products, which is helping to increase the productivity in marine areas. Then some innovations with the calibration of cotton import substitute as well as rubber dams. Then ultrasonic sensor-based pomegranate sprayer. Then walnut dehuller, drift control shield for boom sprayer, turmeric planter, coca pod for breaker. Then we have fruit grader, cassava harvester, rotary weeder. So all these glimpses come up with the imaging technologies for agriculture also, where we have come up with innovation with sensors and camera in the field of farm equipment, which help in order to maintain the water levels in irrigation and soil, help to maintain the food storage, early detection of pest, emission sensors, then tagging of livestock help to maintain the management of livestock production as well as concern, then tagging of other natural resources, tagging of trucks and shipping containers, then marketing, banking and distribution areas. Then we have some innovation in agri-volatic system, or we call as solar farming, where growing crops and generating electricity through PV models and simultaneously from a piece of land. Means a particular land is used where we can go for growing crops also, conserving energy also, and this all will help in order to increase the productivity. Then we have agri-robotics, which helps to minimize the farmer's labor in adverse climatic conditions. Then we can carry out the agriculture operation, or we can say package and practices from harvesting, pruning, weeding, spraying, as well as we have a driverless tractor, sprayer, then sheep rearing, milking, protected cultivation, as well as market functions like storage, packaging, and as well as transport. Then this is the very innovative part of artificial intelligent neural network, which is used for water management, where we can easily identify the areas where the field capacity is going down. We can increase by giving irrigation to that hidden areas through the artificial neural network. Then we have big data analytics. A very good company, we can say Cropin, is moving or doing very well in this concern, where it helps in order to estimate the yield also. It helped to assess the market as well as identify the storage places, as well as determine the prices of the commodity also. Then we have digital farming, where the share of rural India for the smartphone is moving to 48% up to 2020. So as a concern, all the service-based startups are moving under digital farming. Then we have a fusion of technologies, as we discussed, with big data analytics, then information of technology in farming, then GIS-based remote sensing, image processing, digital farming, artificial intelligence, deep machine learning, blockchain technologies, some innovation in sensors and robotics, agri-volatics, and some sensors, like we have high-yielding varieties. Same way, we have some high-yielding sensors, which determines the yield and the productivity of the crops also. Then we move some innovation in secondary agriculture. Secondary agriculture in simple term means food processing and further. As we know very well, there is loss of wastage of food up to 1.3 billion tons. So in order to overcome it and fulfill the upcoming needs, we have come up with innovation in secondary agriculture. Here they have shown the proper picture. We can say how much loss is there due to less storage, or since they are not coming up in processing view. These are the some innovations, or we can say processing products, which are developed from the secondary agriculture. Either it is moving with camel milk products, it deals with soya, or upcoming some ornamental crops, dealing with processing with maize as well as bajra lassi. So these are the some innovation as a concern in secondary agriculture. Now talking about today's scenario of this COVID condition, and we are focusing on Indian health food industry also. Dealing with functional foods, dealing with dairy foods, milk fat is essential for healthy life, dealing with nutrition, sensory satisfaction, fortification of crops in order to increase the yield of that particular crop, then modulation of psychological systems, So all this way move with Indian health and food industry. Then we have major approaches dealing with biofertilizer plants like moringa, sweet potato, nutri millets, and fruits and vegetables. Then we have some biofortified varieties selected by breeding selection like iron-rich pearl millet, zinc-rich rice, some genetically biofertile crops like golden rice, iron rice, where the modification are done in order to increase their nutritional level as well as fulfilling the food security as well as nutritional security. These are the some glimpses showing the grain processing sector, how they are coming up with value addition as well as we can say employment generation. These are the some example of millet milling pilot plant, which is helping to increase the employment as well as value addition. These are the some millet based product, or we can say some nutritional based product dealing with little millet cookies, then sport food mix, diabetic mix, then flakes, as well as coming up with Foxtech millet kaka. Some agro techniques in order to increase the production of the potato crop dealing with French fries. Then coconut sweet chips, very important enterprise where it is moving with value addition as well as increasing the productivity of the crops. Then we have some innovative value addition in wine and ethanol, moving with fuel consumption and helping in dealing with increasing the income of the farmers. Then we have value addition in floriculture part, which deals with foreign exchange also. Then we have farm banana fiber as a fabric, which is used in both textile industry as well as the livestock industry dealing with. Then we have industrial scale jute yarn, which is helping to increase the productivity or increase the value addition of that particular crop. Then GeoNet from coconut fiber for soil stabilization. Then we have EcoHeli and textile colors for the vegetable resources. Then we have very innovative mushroom developed, which is rich in vitamin A and E, mostly found in northeast as well as the upper hilly areas of India, covering Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Sikkim. And if you see the price level, it is reaching up to 12,000 to 14,000. Per kg, and this is the common moral mushroom which is found in northeast areas. Then we have some edible insect which are consumed as a food also, the upcoming agave worm, honey pot ants, leaf cutter ants, lemon ants, bamboo worm, bee, kikera and mealworm. Then we have some edible seaweeds which are consumed, or we can say plant-based meats, which is upcoming innovation coming in agriculture. Then we have seaweeds for increasing the nutrition for the livestock, like nutraceuticals as well as biofertilizers. Now the new term is coming up, biostimulant also. All this is helping the agriculture and allied activities. Then we have aquatic nutrients, which increasing the fish feed and increasing its productivity. Then from wealth from waste also, we have coming up with waste for agriculture, biofertilizer from fish waste, eco brick feed block. So all this will come or will work together when we focus on some institutional approach, that is the farmer producer organization self-help group. For this, we have organized the stakeholders or the farmers in self-help groups, farmer innovation groups, or farmer producer organization, or lastly is dealing with the startups. So major focus was the health and employment, focusing on youth and women, enhance efficiency and reduce cost, water and energy, diversify the, enhance the income, process and prosper. All this will work out with the help of collaboration of industries, incubators and research and development labs. For this, we require innovation from all parts. It is moving with public, national, international, private sector, NGOs, individual, institutional organizations, focusing with products, services, processes, organization, governance, social sector, urban and rural people. These are the innovation pillars, how it moves. It moves with the human and capital tools, focusing the mindset, talent, knowledge intensive entrepreneurs, B2B connectivity, through information technology, new collaboration, social networks, changing nature, multidisciplinary means collaboration with industry, agriculture, as well as service sector. Then global dimension means innovation, moving from local innovation to global one. Then further help of governance, market, finance, and lastly deals with measurement or benchmark analysis. Now, agribusiness system, you know very well, it is moving with input subsystem, that is the seed, fertilizer, agrochemical, machinery, manufactured, imported or distributed goods. Then moving with production, that is food grain, horticulture, produce, dairy, poultry, fishery. Then processing, moving with transporting the output of production subsystem with different degree of processing. Then we move with marketing, that is transferring of goods from one subsystem to another, logistic, retailing, wholesaling. And lastly, the support system, that is the government. If you see the nature and scope of agribusiness as a concern, it is moving or it is explored due to this entrepreneurship and the startup activities. The major components of agribusiness, we know very well, that is the agri food and input area, then the production and warehousing area, logistic and distribution, further trading, processing, food and retail, and food services. All this will work in transferring the farmers into agripreneurs. For this, we require sensitization. For this only, we are conducting this webinar, then training and capacity building, legal and commercial handling. The major challenges for the stakeholders is in order to organize them, either through farmer's view, for in order to overcome less resources and come up with new innovation. State government must come together in order to come up with some timely release of subsidies, dealing of training processes, premium and claiming subsidy to the non-crop growers. Bank and financial institution must promote in order to working this, then insurance companies. So all this will help in disruptive models and digital transformation. These are the some policy and amendments under intellectual property rights, which have helped to clarify as well as simplify the upcoming scenario of the startups. Now, talking about the agribusiness incubation and agri startups, major focus is given on disruptive innovation, smart intervention, ease of operation, and enhance of revenue, where it focuses on novelty, quality, innovation, and lastly, entrepreneurship. New generation agribusiness incubators are focusing on farmer to folk area concern. These are the some institutions which are focusing on agri startup, that is NAM Hyderabad, ICRISIT Hyderabad, Manage Hyderabad, CCS NIAM Jaipur, then Bagalkot, ISR Kozhikode, CFT Cochin, Bionest Cochin, then some public private university, then TNU, Bhubaneswar, Kozhikode, and Chennai. Then some product-based startup are focused, or the livestock startups are focused by IRA Izzatnagar, then NRC PIC Guwahati, IRA New Delhi, then Central Institute of Processing and Harvest Punjab, then Nutri Hub, Indian Institute of Millet Research Hyderabad, then Central Institute of Agriculture Engineering Bhopal, NRI Cuttack, Kazri, Izzatnagar, then Technology Business Incubator University of Hyderabad, then Fishery Focus in Mumbai. Major support given by the incubator is concerned with mentoring and networking, then sharing the facilities and infrastructure, helping them to business plan and development, market linkage, and lastly, employment generation. Same way, the desired support move with the mentoring and funding way. These are the some investment which are carried out in the agriculture in order to promote the startups. Major fields are dealing with agriculture, biotechnology, online farm to consumer, farm management software, sensing and IoT robotics, mechanization equipment, novel farming system, food safety and traceability. If you see the scenario of the startup, the scenario moves with the different fields, from the finance, infrastructure, then supply chain, farm, and data analytics. The major domains of agri startups in India are focusing from digital farming, then value chain, then moving with service-based startups. The major firms in agri tech or agri startups are the Tata Consultancy Services, Tech Mahindra, Infosys, Cognizant, Accenture, ITC. The major priorities given in this field and the institution who are helping are the Aspire, NewGen, IDEC, NSTMS, then Atal Incubation Center, CIFAC, then MSME, then moving with NABARD. These are the some glimpses of geo-susceptible solutions, IoT enablers, a comprehensive picture showing the upcoming AI and MI system in agriculture. These are the some example of startups like FarmZen. Then we have CropIn, Fussel, Future Farm. All these are the upcoming startups who are working in different sectors of agriculture. And they are helping in order to define the startup, that is the action or process for setting something in motion. These are the some examples of startups again. Mostly we have agri-tech startups dealing with technologies. Then we have farms and nursery-based startups. Then some startup dealing with aggregation of resources, then agri-inputs and consultation and support. These are the some glimpses again dealing with agri-startups, which focus on smart small testing, disease forecasting control, bioformulation, value addition, focusing cold storage, drones, sensors. Some online marketing, farm nursery and aggregated based startups. Agri inputs dealing with bio inputs, organic manure, bioformulation. Then consultation startup focusing on crop advisories, credit facilities, further value chain, knowledge upgradation, certification and veterinary services. This shows the graphical picture, the major proportion of agri-tech startups. And major challenges is dealing with funding, then coming up with the team composition also, then proper direction in order to start that particular startups. So all these challenges are overcome by setting up agribusiness incubators. So they provide some market linkage, policy support, as well as price affordability to the farmers. Agripreneur support is given, moving with learning phase, other ground ventures, way forward, moving with innovation platform. So up these challenges and the fulfillment, moving with sustainable agriculture, dealing with profit, prestige, partnership in agriculture, farm business, dealing with agriculture, South, a profession, and healthy and happy India. So for this, we are running RQI Raftar based agribusiness incubation. The major objectives are in order to fulfill the lab to land by promotion of new technologies and varieties through agri startups. Pan India basis, it is situated with 5 knowledge partner, that is Manage Hyderabad, V1, that is National Institute of Agriculture Marketing, NIAM, Jaipur, then Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi, then University of Agriculture Sciences, Dharwad, and in Northeast, we have Assam Agriculture University, Jorhat. Under these 5 knowledge partners, we have 25 regional agribusiness incubator, that is the RQI Raftar incubator. It is situated in mostly in agriculture universities, research stations, then upcoming innovation benchmark centers also. Talking in Gujarat, we have Anand Agriculture University, Gujarat, also running the same scenario program. So talking about the NIAM Agribusiness Incubator, we mostly focus on upcoming innovations in farm mechanization, biotechnology and bioinformatics, post-harvest processing, agri-food processing, then some innovative fields in agronomy, soil and agri-health services, farm retailing, precision farming, then agri-value chain, supply chain management, IoT as well as ICT in agriculture, and lastly, artificial intelligence in agriculture. We have hand-holding with some RQI Raftar incubators, which are situated in Odisha, that is NRI Cuttack, then Agriculture University in Jobner, IIT Kharagpur, Bihar Agriculture University also. The major activities, we run 2 important programs. Those programs are, first is Agripreneur Orientation Program, where we come up with 2 months of in-house training, as well as we can say internship or online training due to this COVID conditions. And since this is a government program, we do not have any registration fees and concern. You have to only apply for this particular program with your innovative idea. Anyone who is interested in agri-entrepreneurship can participate. There is no any basic qualification. Only we come up with 3 major components. That is the innovation part. Second is the business model, innovative business model, which is scalable, viable. And lastly, very important, that is the how that particular business model is helping the farmers or social impact part. Then we provide stipend of 10,000 per month. Then we provide grant in aid up to 5 lakhs for the eligible agripreneurs by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. So agripreneur orientation program is focused on those agripreneurs which have idea at very, we can say, superficial level. Only that particular startup is at idea stage, we come up with this agripreneur orientation program. Then we have a startup agribusiness incubation program for mature startups. Means those startups where the idea is converted into prototype and prototype into minimum viable product. Here also we come up with 2 months in-house training for the selected incubatees or selected participants. Only compliances part is that that particular company must be a registered. It must be an Indian startup as per Department of Promotion and Internal Trade notification. Then we provide funding up to 25 lakh rupees for their marketing activities, then working capital, capital expenditure, and other contingency charges. For this, we yearly we come up with rolling advertisement. For that, we come up with screening at two levels. We call up the applications. These applications are scrutinized by the internal committee. The best ideas are selected. Then pitch deck presentation is carried out. After pitch deck presentation, we go for 2 months of training. In this 2 months of training, we come up with one-to-one interaction sessions with the internal as well as external mentors. Then we have industry collaborations. We come up with preparation of business plan, detailed project report. And after that, we have second and final selection by the Center of Excellence and Incubation Committee, which come up with the funding scenario. In these 2 months, we have a unique mix of academics as a practice. We move with step by step of first idea validation. Then we move with a very important part, that is the entrepreneurial marketing. Then some innovation management, or we can say exploring part of that particular innovation. Then we move with business finance. And lastly, the compliance part, that is the legal and intellectual properties. Further, we move with practical exposure, with market survey. We come up with some industrial attachment, collaboration, as well as hands-on training for the particular field. Then we have some professional skill mentorship also, dealing with preparation of detailed project report, as well as preparing business presentation. For this, we have a very proper study material approach also. And this study material is uploaded on the website. These are some glimpses of some study material dealing with frequently asked question dealing with agripreneurship. Then these are some glimpses of visits which we have carried out for the incubatees. It may be agriculture university, then dealing with research stations. The major support, we provide 2 months residential program, but due to this COVID condition, we are conducting this program online. Then we have hands-on training, technical assistance, business mentoring, intellectual property management, seed funding, marketing, and networking. Further, as we know very well, we have discussed that the major eligibility for the agripreneur orientation program is we require one unity idea, and a rough initial business plan must be prepared through the side of the agripreneurs. Then startup also, only one important part, that the particular company or the entity must be registered under the DPPIT notification. Beyond this 5 lakh and 25 lakh, the government has encouraged the upcoming incubatees that if they work in very proper way during this 2 months training program and their full-fledged 1 year program, a cash prize of 1 lakh rupee is given to the well-doing incubatees as well as the startups. Then these are some glimpses of CCS NIAM incubated supported startups. Startup dealing with agri value chain and processing. This startup by Satendra Lihare, who is working in Chhattisgarh, and he has come up with an innovative model for the procurement as well as selling of the indigenous products and helping the tribal areas as well as the farmers in that particular region. Then this is the Himalayan Hemp Industry Private Limited working. It is coming up with the value-added product from the hemp and converting into sanitary pads. Then these are the list of the agri-processing value chain based startups. Sudhanshu Gupta, who has come up with processing of wheels and technology. Rajesh Kumar Oza is also coming up with the processing unit for the custard apple. Then we have some startup dealing with IoT or ICT based. This is Poultrify Manganese Private Limited, who has come up with the app-based model, which is helping in order to determine the marketplace for poultry industries, as well as the demand and supply of poultry products. Then again, the list, Sheikh Akbar Ali is dealing with virtual aquaculture consulting. Then Madhurita Gupta has come up with Indian first veterinary-based telemedicine mobile app for transferring animal healthcare. Then natural resource management-based startup is the by Buddhi Prakash, who has developed a natural polymer which is easily degradable in the soil. It conserves the water and increase the farmer productivity. This startup is now working with Japanese-based firm for the further innovation part. Now we have agri-logistic-based startup name as Apna Godam, where Sanjay Agarwal has come up with utilization of unused rural areas, converted them into warehouses, and come up with an app-based model which can determine the collateral facility also. So these are the some list. Then we have agri-commodity assigned technologies by Three Stake Labs, developed by Dr. Santosh, who has come up with an innovative model of handheld agri-commodity assigned machine, which can move from, which can be taken from one place to another in order to determine the quality as well as the grading and standard concept of the cereal pulses also. Then we have renewable based energy startups by Dr. Deepak Singh, who has come up with a concept of solar power generation automation unit, where the electric where the motor, when there is no light for as a concern in the field, we can easily use the solar based app and can use for that irrigation purposes also. Then we have Alloy ECL Private Limited, who has come up and developed 100% eco-friendly aloe vera batteries. Then we have Zellos Green India, who has helped in order to waste management from the all the agriculture produce marketing areas. All the waste which is dumped, it is converted into biogas and further into biofuel. Then we have Scrimis Solution, who has converted the wastage plastic into biofuel, and that biofuel is used to run the tractor, diesel motors and broilers in agriculture. These are the some innovations by different incubators. Some biotechnology based startup is developed by Aqua Biotech LLP, who has developed a fish feed with natural medicinal additives and increased the productivity of the marine areas. Then we have organic farming as well as value addition indigenous technology based startups, who has developed value-added products from cow dung and urine. Then high quality A2 milk, now we have seen with an organic milk concept for buffalo milk, has come up with Meyer Bisoni. Then we have organic products developed by the Akaya Organic Private Limited. Chalu Nitani has developed organic based food products which is focusing traditional crop like beetroot, karambala and karonda. Then organic honey production by the Bee World by Praveen. Then we have organic farming dealing with by Umesh. So we started this particular incubation program in the year 2018-19, and up to 2021, we have incubated near about 115 startups. From this, 59 startups have been recommended as well as funded. So these are the some glimpses. Here you can apply for this particular programs, that is Agripreneur Orientation Program and Startup Incubation Program, by directly visiting our website. There you can very simple way, a Google Doc form is there. We have to fulfill some major component questions concerned with this, or you can apply also through email, or by offline also you can send your innovative business model to our chief operating officer. So these are the links to apply for this particular program. These are the concern for the other innovative concept, that is the Startup India. Atal Innovation Mission is also focusing with agriculture and allied sectors. This is dealing with innovation organization dealing with entrepreneurship and development center, where they give a loan as well as equity form of 25 lakh rupees for the upcoming projects. Then Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme developed by NABARD is also focusing, where 25% of the project cost, back-end subsidy is given to the upcoming agripreneurs. Then we have PPP model, that is Venture Capital Finance Assistance Scheme, which focus and give funding up to 50 lakh rupees or 26% of the promoter's equity. Then we have Aspire, that is micro, small, medium enterprises, where they help as well as give direction to the upcoming agripreneurs. So you can approach us in order to apply for this particular program and the upcoming project concern for the agribusiness startups. Thank you. So if any queries, any concern, you can come up, please.
Thank you very much, sir, for your informative presentation. I would like to request all the students, if they have any queries regarding the whole concept, you can ask questions.
Yeah, sure.
Sir, one question is that is IUE?
I'm not getting, what is
IUE?
IUE is actually one of the innovation method of using light. With the help of the determination of light, you can come up with increasing the productivity. Means there are two components, vegetative stage and reproductive stage. So with the help of light, you can increasing the photosynthesis activity, and that photosynthesis activity will come up into increase the vegetative as well as the reproductive stage of the crops. So there are some agri-based startup who are working under this IUE concept.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Yeah.
In the end of this webinar, I'd like to vote for a thanks for this informative webinar of yours. I guess all the students are getting the information very well. I would like to. Yes, sir. Yes.
Dr. Kadam.
Yes, sir.
Basically, if you see, your presentation was very exhaustive.
Sir, little bit louder. I'm not able to hear you, sir.
Now, can you hear me?
Yeah, please.
Is it audible? So, if you see, your presentation was very exhaustive, and please, you can stop this presentation so the bandwidth can be increased also. That may be. Sharing.
One minute.
So basically, what happens whenever the student, those who want to apply, they are not able to understand why and how, how they have to approach to the funding agency.
Okay. So regarding now funding agency, for the startups, we carry out investor meets. Then we come up for this only, sir. The major concern for the agri incubation is what? We are not only preparing them for this government funding, but we are preparing them in such a way that they can present themselves to the upcoming ventures, upcoming angel investors, and upcoming investment organization also. So in order to approach them, a very simple way I can say, the upcoming agripreneurs, if they can register their self on the Startup India, there is a separate dashboard in order to attract the investors. So there they have come up with a paradigm that you have to register yourself, your startup company, your business model, your financial progress. And on that basis, the investor circle is there, or ecosystem is there. They will approach you and they will come up with the views concerned for the funding. Then we have.
They have to register the Startup India.
Yeah, Startup India.
Okay. Yeah. Please carry on. You want to say something?
Then, sir, startup, okay, this is only for the startup. Then concern with entrepreneurs. Now, there are two terms again, conventional, we can say enterprise and innovation enterprise. Innovation enterprise is moving with startups, but conventional enterprise is moving with MSME. If you visit the website of MSME also, same scenario they have. Whatever innovation they have to come up, they register there, the business model, the same financial progress. There also they have an investor ecosystem and you can approach the concern investors. Then one more thing we have, that is agri-clinic and agri-business centers. This is also working pan-India. There also they are promoting the upcoming agripreneurs who can directly register there. There also they have 2 months incubation program, or we can say training program. There also they conduct
Managed by Manage Hyderabad.
Manage Hyderabad is the, we can say, a knowledge partner. But under knowledge partner, we have near about 669 centers, means nodal institutes, which are working pan-India. And there also, they conduct 2 months training program, prepare detailed project report. And that detailed project report is presented before the NABARD-sponsored banks. Means NABARD is the head body. Under NABARD, we have nationalized banks which come forward and help in funding the upcoming agripreneurs.
Dr. Kadam, suppose a university or an institution want to come forward for starting any kind of a venture, how you support?
Sir, regarding university, if that particular entity is interested to start any venture or anything, first of all, we have to focus on the business model, and regarding the compliances part, it come up with registration. I think the moving with the venture part, you can come up with an incubation center also. If there is an incubation center, you can promote your own students also in order to come up with good ventures, with good projects. I think in agriculture, we have a RAVE-based projects. That RAVE-based project can come up with some industrial-based approaches where they can come up with some innovation projects, and this can be collaborated and been promoted.
So this collaboration can be done with the CCS NIAM or someone else?
CCS NIAM, sir, collaboration in a, such a sense that we can promote the students, we can come up with some workshops, we can groom them, and we can tell them to apply for this upcoming programs also. So then, then Startup India has some schemes, mostly focused on entrepreneurship. If you visit the website of Startup India, they are focusing such universities, organizations, they are giving infrastructure funding also, separate funding, that you can come up with some entrepreneur cell or incubation center, or they have an Innovate or Eureka, like in IIT Bombay, they have a Eureka-based cell. Actually, this all is supported by the Startup India only. So a very well full-fledged university organization can come up and apply for this also. Then Manage Hyderabad has a separate concept of agripreneur orientation. Means what they're doing, they are helping the organizations by coming up with the propaganda of promotion as well as carrying out the activities in order to come up with good projects. For that also, they are funding. So you can apply in that particular direction also.
Anyway, I think those who are listening to this webinar, they are acquainted with the kind of things which are required to become the entrepreneur or to start the startup. And they can apply for the different kind of the funding as well as to apply the business ideas into the reality.
Sure.
Yes, sir. So, sir, lastly, for this webinar, I like to thank sir for giving us such an informative webinar on behalf of my college as well as the entire community. I would also like to thank you, sir, for today's webinar, for your enthusiastic support, and also a special thanks for all the teaching as well as non-teaching staff for their coordination. especially thanking all the students who have given the active participation in this webinar. And with this all kind message, I would like to end this today's seminar. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much. I want to thank you on behalf of CCS NIAM, NIAM Agribusiness Incubator, to our Dean, College of Agriculture, as well as all the faculty, students who have given their precious time and work out in this particular direction. And I think I will get good applications, as well as upcoming agripreneurs will communicate and we will flourish the agri ecosystem. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, team PU webinar, for providing such kind of platform to discuss with the students.
Sure, sir. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you. Have a good day, sir.